Let me first of all make it clear that Ahmadi Muslims are entirely sincere in their efforts to promote peace in the world and always endeavor to practice what they preach. We are the same from the inside as the outside and live our lives according to what we believe in our hearts to be true Islam. I would also like to make it clear that when Ahmadi Muslims spread teachings of peace, security, and love for all, they are not presenting anything new, but are manifesting only the true teachings of Islam. In every respect, Islam is a religion of peace, harmony, tolerance, and compassion. Over the past year, one particular group has viciously spread its network of terror and has become a cause of major concern for the world. I am speaking of the group of extremists commonly known as ISIS or IS. The actions of this extremist group are not only impacting Muslim countries, but also countries in Europe and further afield are also being affected by its brutalities. The fact that all of this is being done in the name of Islam sincerely grieves and pains all true and peace-loving Muslims, because such brutal and inhuman ideologies have nothing to do with the religion whatsoever. Rather, in every way and at every level, Islam's real teachings are of peace and security for all people. In terms of extremism, let it be absolutely clear that wherever and whenever anyone seeks to justify their hate-filled atrocities or injustices in the name of Islam, they should be condemned. Let it also be very clear that such acts have no relation whatsoever to the true and peaceful teachings of Islam. There is no doubt that major powers and certain political and religious leaders are motivated by greed and their vested interests. Their selfish desires have contributed to the desperate state of affairs that we are witnessing, and so responsibility also lies with them. The world is being consumed by various issues that are leading to frustration and resentment, which in turn are undermining peace. Seated before me are various politicians, influential figures, and well-educated people, and so I wish to reiterate that you should all try your level best to influence your governments and leaders positively towards establishing justice and honesty at all levels. These are the keys to solving the many international and domestic crises of our time.